Why was Al defeated?
What? That's wrong. I'm next.
No, I'm next.
I try to envision the events that take place as individual elements. I can then make a note of each one. But I gain a better understanding when I combine all of these again, as a whole. Which is why I have very bad handwriting. Any other questions?
Oh! Can you tell me if there's something that you're not good at, or maybe something that you're scared of?
Something I'm scared of?
What? Yeah, right. Elle's not scared of anything.
Well, I suppose. Monsters.
Me too. I am too.
Dummy, Elle's not the same as you.
There are many types of monsters in this world. Monsters who cause trouble without showing themselves, their elusive presence haunting every corner of our lives, leaving us in a constant state of unease. They manipulate from the shadows, leaving behind a trail of chaos and confusion. Then there are the monsters who abduct children, stealing away their innocence and purity, leaving families shattered and communities in despair. These monsters strike fear into the hearts of parents, a chilling reminder of the vulnerability of those we hold dear. Monsters who devour dreams, feeding on the hopes and aspirations of individuals, extinguishing the flickering flames of ambition. They leave behind a wake of shattered goals and broken spirits, turning once vibrant souls into mere shells of their former selves. Monsters who suck blood, preying on the life force of others, draining them of vitality and energy. These creatures thrive on the suffering and weakness of their victims, their insatiable thirst never quenched. Monsters who tell nothing but lies. Lying monsters are a real nuisance, their deceitful nature tearing apart trust and distorting reality. They weave intricate webs of falsehoods, manipulating others for their own gain. With each fabricated word, they further entangle their unsuspecting victims, leaving them lost and confused. Lying monsters are much more cunning than others. They possess a twisted intelligence, allowing them to pose as humans despite their complete lack of understanding of the human heart. They wear a mask of normalcy, blending seamlessly into society while harboring a dark secret within. They eat even though they've never experienced hunger. Their consumption is not driven by necessity or desire, but by a relentless hunger for power and control. They feast upon the vulnerabilities of others, exploiting weaknesses for their own twisted pleasure. They study, even though they have no interest in academics. Their pursuit of knowledge is not fueled by curiosity or a thirst for enlightenment, but by a sinister agenda. They acquire information and skills to manipulate and deceive, furthering their ability to ensnare unsuspecting prey. They seek friendship, even though they do not know how to love. Their desperate longing for connection is a facade, a mask they wear to lure in the unsuspecting. They mimic human emotions without truly understanding the depth of genuine affection, leaving behind a trail of broken hearts and shattered trust. If I were to encounter such monsters, I would likely be eaten by them, because in truth, I am that monster. The realization hits like a thunderbolt, shattering the illusions of my own innocence. The darkness that lurks within me, the capacity for deceit and manipulation, mirrors the very monsters that haunt my nightmares. By acknowledging the monster within, I gain the power to confront and tame it. I can choose to reject the path of destruction and embrace empathy and authenticity instead. For in the darkest depths of our souls, there lies the potential for both monsters and angels. It is up to us to decide which one we will become. I have chosen. Have you?